The trip to Tokyo started to fall apart for Nene Leakes on Sunday's episode of The Real Housewives of Atlanta. It all started when Nene worried that she couldn't make contact with her husband, Greg. If you watch The Real Housewives of Atlanta online, you know that Greg has been battling cancer. As such, it's been a difficult time for Nene and her entire family. When Nene ultimately made contact with Greg, he could only muster sorry for worrying her. That did not go down well. "That doesn't really work. I hear I'm sorry all the time," she snapped. "I'm super stressed out. I feel like I've been trying to support you and I'm over here falling to pieces, and I don't have anybody here to lift me up." Nene went on to reveal that her husband is not the same man he was before the cancer diagnosis. "I don't have that same nurturing type of Greg that I'm used to and that I love," she complained. "I try to have patience with the new person he is, but it's not easy. I understand Greg is sick. I just need a little piece of him to come back." Nene later aired her frustrations to her friend, Cynthia Bailey, who stopped by to comfort her. "I get that he's overwhelmed, he's scared, but I am overwhelmed too," she sobbed. "It's a lot for me. The fact that's me and him can't talk. I feel like we're going back the same way we came. We be breaking up," she continued. "I hate when people say stuff like, 'You're so strong, I still have feelings.' I hate that word, 'I have feelings,'" Nene added. Cynthia wanted her friend to keep going because she would regret it. "Yeah, but I'm tired. I'm tired of having to put on a face and take care of everybody, and nobody is trying to take care of me." In a touching scene, Greg sent a bouquet for his wife, and Eva was on hand to help Nene out. Eva read out the note that came with the flowers. "You are for me. When you are in pain, I hurt too," it began. "Forgive me my errors and let me drown you in my love. Hurt no more, for I feel the pain I inflicted on you. Let me back in your heart so that I can touch it and mend our love as we continue to grow with each other. I love you so much. Your husband, friend, and biggest supporter." "That's beautiful," Eva said after finishing reading it. "I want to see my vows all the way through. Can I do this? Am I capable?" Nene asked in a confessional. "I wanna make it, but it's a tough time." Elsewhere, the other big event was Eva's bachelorette party. There was a stripper, but the ladies took major issue with the fact the man did not want to strip naked. "Isn't that what they're paid for? I don't know how much Tanya paid for the stripper, honey, but she needs to get a refund," Cynthia said. "Anybody could have did what he did." But the ladies made the best of a bad situation and had a good time with one another. "Who knew all it needed was a pickle to make me laugh and have fun?" Nene asked. Elsewhere, Portia finally opened up about her issues with Dennis. She said he had been talking to exes behind her back. "Now I've been here, I've been missing him, and it just makes me wanna say, you know what, forget anyone Dennis has dated in his past. Let's just concentrate on the love we have for each other and where we're trying to go," she said. When the lovers resolved everything, Candy stepped in to apologize for the things she said about Dennis. "I feel pretty sy about some of the things I said about Dennis," she said. Candy then admitted that she had similar issues when she got together with Todd Tucker, and they're happily in love. "So with that, I apologize for all that I said. For real," she said through tears, and the pair hugged it out. What are your thoughts on the action? Hit the comments below. RHOA airs Sundays on Bravo.